as if their opinion is an end-all. Sorry. Just doesn't do it for me. Someone said, Buddhism is rational, after I did my Buddhism video. Sorry, that's not a refutation. All you're doing is being contrary. You're not backing it up whatsoever. You know that you have no argument, so you're just saying, you're just stating something that's patently false, that I've shown to be patently false. If you're going to refute my points, then refute my fucking points. But I say that all the time. Brett Keane says that all the time. So many atheists say that all the time. Please, just refute what I'm saying. You know, I mean, you can make fun of me, but while you're making fun of me, refute what I fucking say, please. And they never do it. Not once. They've never done it. They never will fucking do it. They're just not interested in it. I wonder how long I've been talking now. I wonder how far I am from the 1 hour mark. I can't see it on the camera. I can't stop it. I guess I'm just going to talk until it says there's no more tape. So if I'm interrupted mid-sentence, that's why. Of course, you know when the video is going to run out. You have the convenience of seeing a little thing on the bottom there, a little red line, drawing ever nearer to the close. Who am I talking to? No one's watching this right now. Are you watching this right now? If so, you must really fucking like me. Because this is not the kind of thing I would expect my subscribers to fucking watch. It's just too fucking dull, too fucking real for most of you. It really is too fucking real for most of you. You don't want to hear about this shit. You really don't. I guess if you're still listening now, you do. But the people who stop watching this, they don't want to hear about this shit. They're not at least a bit fucking interested in this. This is completely fucking dull to them. I don't think I would even be able to watch this, because I'm no better. I just want to be entertained. Not out here to be enlightened. Not out here to learn anything. Just want a distraction from my fucking life. And my life isn't even that bad. It doesn't even need a lot to... I don't even need these distractions. But what is life anyway? I mean, when we talk about these things as distractions, I mean, when you talk about movies as distracting from life, aren't movies part of life? Isn't watching videos on YouTube part of life? I mean, what exactly falls into the... If not, what exactly falls into the category of life? I mean, it seems like a lot of people, when they say life, they just mean having sex. That's pretty much what they mean by life. They just want to fuck. That's the only thing they consider a valid use of your time, fucking. And fucking is fun. It's been a while since I've got the chance to do it, but it's a lot of fun. And, actually, masturbating is more fun. Because, really, no one knows what you want like you do. At least that's the way I view it. Maybe I just haven't met the right person yet. A lot of people tell me that when I say stuff like that. You just haven't met the right person. Yeah, I guess not. Used to, had one relationship in my life. One real relationship. With a woman named, well, I won't say her name because it's mean. Someone else might know her by some strange coincidence and tell her that there's this video floating around with her name in it. But she was an older lady, not like, not in her 90s or something. She was in her 30s and I was still a teenager, not like young teenager. I was like 17, 18 years old when we started the relationship. And I deluded myself into thinking that I was in love. It became apparent to me very shortly after moving in with her that I wasn't in love, but it was too sweet of a situation to drop because she would go off to work every day, I would sleep till noon, I'd get up, I'd fuck around on the internet, and about an hour before she got home, I would clean up the house, I'd help her son with his homework, she'd come back, I'd watch Cops with her on TV, and the news, stuff like that. We'd talk for a while. We'd go in the bedroom. Sometimes I would give her a massage because she had a lot of muscle problems in her back. And every once in a while, we'd fuck. And that was the relationship. And when we fucked, I was pretending that she was someone else. All the time. You have to pretend that you're that when you're fucking someone so regularly like that, you've got to pretend there's someone else or you just can't fucking get it up. At least I can't. I'm just not excited enough about fucking the same person over and over again. On the same coin, I'm not interested in fucking a different person every night because I just can't go through that whole fucking trauma of actually having to be naked around someone, let alone, touch them and let them, I don't even want to get into that, but it's kind of repellent to me. I notice a lot of people are coming around to that attitude about sexuality in these days. It's not that I don't like sexuality. I'm very sexual. It's just, it's not very, this is not the kind of thing that you can explore with someone, I guess. Especially when you have, the kind of fantasies that I do. Can't really get into that, though, too much. A little too bizarre for most people to understand. A lot of masochistic tendencies, though, in myself. Very submissive when it comes to that kind of thing. And I think that was a problem because she knew me as being a very dominant person, and sexually I'm very submissive, and it was very not what she was expecting. And not what I was expecting, because she was my first, and to date my only, although I frequently lie to people, tell them that I have had sex with, hundreds of thousands of people, whatever. The internet is the perfect place to lie about that kind of stuff. Yeah. Shut up, dog. Everyone's cock on the internet is 9 inches long. Everyone's fucked 1,000 women. I've only fucked one. Been blown by 3. Actually I have fucked 2, now that I think about it. Sorry. I had a very, very brief and very raunchy sexual encounter with a friend of my brother's, his girlfriend. Which was kind of stupid because she had herpes. I didn't catch herpes, luckily enough. As most people who fuck people with herpes don't, but I was lucky that I didn't catch that anyway. Because it would really suck to get herpes from such an unsatisfying experience as that. Very unsatisfying, mostly for the reason that it was very, very brief, very unromantic, just very much just masturbation using another person. And that's really been all my sexual encounters, now that I think about it. Even the ones that were, dressed up as being romantic, it was always just masturbation with another person involved. And the only times that I ever really got off with my old girlfriend, my ex, was when she would, talk dirty about the fantasies that I'd shared with her, and stuff that we said we were going to do back when we were just talking, and stuff that we never actually did once we started fucking. Very sad. Misrepresented. Of course, I guess I could have had that stuff happen had I pushed for it. And maybe I should have. But that's the nature of life. We go through life and we have regrets. Hasn't changed in thousands of years. Don't expect it to change anytime soon.